Good evening. Welcome to a very special edition of Berkeley Ferndale Unified High School Hockey. Tonight is senior night, where we say goodbye to our seniors who have played so well for Berkeley High School and Ferndale High School, and also honor their parents who sacrificed so much to get their kids to this point. We'll start off by announcing the names of the players. The players skate over to your parents over on the home visitor home bench. First player is James Bala. James Bala began playing hockey when he was 14 years old. His most memorable moment as a hockey player was playing on the pond with his brother and friends. His parents spent a lot on his hockey career, and he thanks his parents because they were always supported throughout his entire hockey career. His future plans was joining the Berkeley Bruins. His most important influence as a hockey player was Bob Probert, because he always loves a good scrap. Also, James would like to wish Ray and Tracy Bala, his parents, a happy 28th anniversary. Next up, Joachim Eriksson. Joachim began playing hockey when he was 6 years old. His most memorable moment as a hockey player was when he scored his first goal. He'd like to thank his parents because all they've done for him. And his future plans after graduation includes finishing Swedish high school, and after that, medical school. The most important influence on him as a hockey player was Kyle Kuby, because his calves are larger than anyone I have ever seen. Speaking of whom, Kyle Kuby. Kyle Kuby began playing hockey when he was 6 years old. His most memorable moment as a hockey player was when he scored his first varsity goal. He believes his parents spent about $15,000 on his hockey career. He wants to thank his parents because they've always supported him and drove him to all the tournaments and games. His future plans for graduation include going to Purdue to study to be an aerospace engineer. The most important influence on him as a hockey player was his coaches, because they helped him to get better. Next up is Robert McDonald. Robert began playing hockey when he was 8 years old. His most memorable moment as a hockey player is when he got the MVP at the Big Chill tournament. His parents have spent a lot on his hockey career, and he'd like to thank his parents because they dropped him on his head enough to be inspired enough to be a goalie. His future plans after he graduates includes going to college to become a geomedical engineer. I can't even read this right now. Geo-something engineer, I apologize. The most important influence on him as a hockey player was Dominik Hasek, because of his unconventional style. And now we're going to introduce the captains. Curtis Karn. Curtis Karn began playing hockey when he was 5 years old. His most memorable moment as a hockey player was his sophomore year, scoring 2 goals, including the game winner against Royal Oak. His parents have spent too much on his hockey career. He'd like to thank his parents because playing hockey never would have been possible without him. His future plans after he graduates include studying engineering at either Michigan State, Michigan, or Purdue. His most important influence on him as a hockey player was his first travel hockey coach, Peter Klima, because he taught him to be the hockey player he is today. Shane Goldberg, the last of the Goldberg boys, began playing hockey when he was 5 years old. His most memorable moment as a hockey player was starting his first varsity game with the legend Danny Fritz. His parents have spent more than I plan on paying back on his hockey career. And he'd like to thank his family and friends because they support him throughout his career. His future plans after he graduates include going to college and then signing with the world-class beer league team, the Royal Oak Cardinals. His most important influence on him as a hockey player was his father, because he took me all over to the map to hockey games and was always in the stands. Alex Rolick. Alex began playing hockey when he was 6. His most memorable moment as a hockey player was when the Bears won the second OAA championship against West Bloomfield. His parents have spent a space program's budget worth on his hockey career, and he'd like to thank his parents because he always believed in him, even when he didn't. His future plans after he graduates include the University of Michigan, Forbes 500, the White House, the moon, not necessarily in that order. The most important influence on him as a hockey player was Steve Yzerman, because he was the captain of his favorite team. Zach Siegel. Zach started playing hockey when he was 5 years old. His most memorable moment was when the fans rushed the ice after they won the league championship last year. His parents have spent his college fund on his college career, hockey career rather. He'd like to thank his family and teammates because they were always there to support him. His plans for graduation include going to Michigan State to get huge before signing with the Wings. And his most important influence on him as a hockey player was Steve Yzerman, because he was a great role model on and off the ice. And finally, Stephen Rowe. Stephen began playing hockey when he was 7. His most memorable moment as a hockey player was when he won back-to-back OAA championships. His parents have spent their retirement on his hockey career. He'd like to thank his parents because they supported him on all the decisions he made, including the questionable one of becoming a goalie. His future plans for graduation is the Philadelphia Junior Flyers junior hockey team. His most important influence was Eddie Belfour, because this was the goalie for Toronto Maple Leafs growing up. And these are the Berkeley Ferndale seniors and their parents.
How's everybody doing tonight?
Hello.
Chrissy, hey.
Hey, Alex.
How are you?
Alex? Alex, Alex? Hello. I'm Mrs. Garcia. We've heard a lot about you.
He is cute. Stop.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
Welcome to Berkeley Ice Arena for tonight's hockey game between the Berkeley Ferndale United Bears and the Dexter Dreadnoughts. The Bears come into this game with a record of 16-6-2, and Dexter comes in at 14-10, the last regular season game before they go to the playoffs, and we'll be ready with this introductions in just a moment.
Good evening, and welcome to the senior night edition of Berkeley Ferndale Unified High School Hockey. Berkeley and Ferndale High Schools welcome you to Berkeley Ice Arena for today's MHSAA game between the visiting Dexter Dreadnoughts and the Bears. Let's meet the starting lineups for today's game, sponsored by Plastifab Incorporated, our platinum sponsor, an outstanding producer of custom labels, graphics, signage, and specialty printing. We'd also like to thank our gold sponsors, the Bonello Family, Four Seasons Garden Custom Landscape Center, and the Gamay's Lebanese Kitchen and Lounge. Now, starting for Dexter, at right wing, number 13, Fred Burke. At center, number 8, Wes Gilbert. At left wing, number 19, E.J. Gilbert. On defense, number 17, Ben Grover. On defense, number 20, Bill Howitt. And in goal, 35, Zach Richards. The captain for the Dreadnoughts is Ben Grover, with alternate captains Brian Tuzanowski and Tristan Rozek. The head coach of the Dreadnoughts is Brian Sippets, with assistants John Winkleseth and John Grover. And now, starting for the Bears, at forward number 33, Kyle Kuby. Also at forward number 19, Zach Siegel. Also at forward, number 23, Curtis Karn. On the blue line, number 45, Alex Rolick. His defensive partner, number 5, Shane Goldberg. In net, Stephen Rowe. We'd also like to acknowledge seniors Rob McDonald, James Bala, and Joachim Eriksson. Your officials for today's game are referees Mark Stevens and Eric Siegel, with linesman Patrick Labs. One of the most important reasons we have educational athletics is scholarship in the classroom. These games complement learning in the classroom and teach, among other things, the history and healthy respect for our country. So, before we sing the national anthem, on behalf of Joachim Eriksson, we will play the Swedish national anthem. and be good sports by showing respect for the game, each other, and our country by joining Shannon Smith and proudly singing our national anthem.
All right, here we are, ready to go. The teams are getting ready for their setup and get their equipment back on after the national anthem and get ready to go. Senior night, seniors and their parents honored before the game for the Berkeley Ferndale United Bears, and the Dexter Dreadnoughts in here to challenge them tonight. The Dexter Dreadnoughts, they'll be going to the state tournament in Chelsea, and the Bears will be starting their state tournament right here at the Berkeley Ice Arena next Tuesday against the Fraser High School. So we'll be ready. This is a tune-up to get ready for this as they get ready for the state tournament. Don't know that. Yeah, this is the last game before the state tournament begins. So we'll be ready with the start. The seniors have a senior line out there starting. All seniors on the ice for this initial face-off in this game. Berkeley 16-6-2, having a fine season. Face-off control by the Dreadnoughts, Ben Grover. Got into the Berkeley end. Goldberg gets it back into center ice. Dexter picks it up along the boards. Berkeley puts it in there, going in there after it for the Bears, number 33, Kyle Kluby. Put back in Curtis Barnes, but now shot back to center ice. Becker pick it up, roll it. As the Bears go for a line change. Coming out for Dexter. Flip and right on the net, so with no icing call. Rowe fields it there. Get it up. Head to Bonello. Broken up there. Taken by number 9, Derek Smith for Dexter. Puck loose and center ice. Ian Melrose picking it up, skating it in. Knocked off his stick there by number 3, Connor Harmon for Dexter. Puck out to center ice. Lannery waits to his teammate Clear. Sends it in, Dooley. Puck loose. Here comes Dexter. Dexter down and good defensive effort getting back on defense there by Max Dooley to slow down a Dexter skater. Dexter picks it up. Number 5, Sean Fitzsimons. In behind the net. Rowe leaves it for Goldberg. Ahead. Come down the ice, Dooley. And he's met at the blue line and stopped. Looks to be, that's the defensive effort they're going to do. They're just going to meet everybody at the blue line. Well, puck is shot back into the Dexter end, going back after it. Jake Slanderer for Dexter. Kept in by the Bears. Now pushed ahead. Now they have the center ice. Goldberg picks it up. Battle for it along the boards. Goldberg puts it back. All the action's in the most difficult place for me to see right now. Puck along the boards. Coming in with it. Number 33. It's Kyle Kubi. Carries it in. Now Dexter comes out. That's number 8. That's Wes Gilbert with it. Met by, stopped by the Bears. Dow coming down, picking up for the DJ Gilbert for Dexter. Shot back in. They got a tripping call.
Dexter, 19 trips.
Number 19 for Dexter for tripping. So the Bears have this man advantage here at Flannery. Back with it. Over to Rolick. Rolick puts it up on the boards. It's shot back into the Berkeley end. Flannery, Bobby Flannery back to pick it up. Flannery gives it ahead to Riley Leonard. Leonard going down the right wing. Leonard checked there by number 18, Evan Morris, and they battle for it. Flannery keeps it in. And Dexter now does slip it out to center ice. Flannery back to pick it up again. Bears get a line change as Flannery goes back behind his net, comes out. Flannery going down that right wing. Dayton puts it right off the side of the net. Picked up there by number 42, Joachim Eriksson. Skating it in, number 9, Ian Melrose. Was shot off, got knocked, deflected to the side. Back out, Goldberg flipping it into the corner too. To number 33, Kubi. Excuse me. No, that's number 13, Bonello, I guess. Pick up, shot. Save made, and a rebound put in. Anushi shot there by Eriksson, but I don't know who got the rebound. I couldn't see it from here. We'll get the scoring in just a moment.
I got 13 from 9, unless you saw somebody else in there too.
The goal of Bonello. There's Bonello's shot, and it's in. Yeah, from number 9, Ian Melrose. So Dexter now back to full strength there. Tristan Rojek trying to center it. He does get it out there, and a shot taken there by Derek Smith, knocked away by the defense in front. Rojek trying to get it, but the Bears managed to clear it out. Going down the ice and picking it up for Brian Tuzanowski for Dexter. Shot back into the Dexter end. Connor Harmon back to pick it up. No icing. Harmon trying to get it clear, but the Bears are keeping it alive. And now here comes Dexter out with it. Coming down is Rojek. Rojek shot deflected up into the netting. Face off, I'll come here to the stick side of Stephen Rowe. And the Bears, Santiago, tries to clear it, but doesn't get it out. And Simons puts it into the corner. Going there to get it, Freddie Burke. Freddie Burke battling with Kubi for it. Finally, gets knocked away, gets knocked out, back out to the point, but here comes Freddie Burke. Flips it the other way. Went over there to get it is Murphy. Pinched in and kept in by the Bears, by the Dexter Dreadnoughts. Shot back into the Bears' end. Picking it up there, number 45, Alex Rolick. Gets it out to center ice, shot back in by Dexter. Rolick again picks it up. Rolick flips it ahead to Bala. Bala gets it into center ice. Battle for it, and Dexter shoots it back to the Berkeley end. Down. Number 19 picking up there, E.J. Gilbert. Gets it in behind the Berkeley net. Over there, pick it up. Murphy trying to clear it. Christian Santiago ahead to Jervis. Jervis. Ahead, but broke up here. Sean Fitzsimon shoots it back for Dexter. Fitzsimon shot. Knocked away. And here comes Flannery out with it. Flannery going down that left wing. Flannery got caught right with him. And we went down hard down there, but they come back in here and picking it up. The Bears. Karn gets it back. It gets into the center ice. And shot in by number 13, Freddie Burke, for the Dexter Dreadnoughts. Picking up number 55, Evan Tarnopol. Ahead to number 43, Kevin Jervis. Jervis gets it out to center ice. Went chasing after it, Zach Siegel. Karn's got it. Karn shot, knocked away by the goaltender, Zach Richards. And here comes Dexter back the other way. This is number shot up, and a glove save made by Stephen Rowe. Goldberg flips it ahead. Melrose, but broken up by Dexter. Dexter controlling it. Centered there by number 9, Derek Smith. Over to Rojek. Back of the point, shot in. Deflected by the defense in front. Dexter still trying to get an offense set up. Goldberg picks it up. Skates around behind his own net. Gets the rush started. Gets it out ahead to Bonello. Going to go all the way down the ice, and that's going to be an ice. He's going to bring it all the way back. Tried to get that outlet pass to Bonello. It was just a little too far. So a face-off comes back into the Berkeley end. Berkeley leads this one 1-0. 8:22 remaining here in the first period. Jervis in here to take the face-off against Wes Gilbert. Controlled by the Bears. Rolick flips it up to Jervis. Jervis ahead to Dooley. And shot back in, but Karsma picks it up and shoots it down the ice. That will be an icing again as it goes all the way down. Again, the faceoff back into the Bears' end. Bears control the faceoff. Karsma over to Rolick. Back the other way. Austin picks it up for the Bears. Austin back over to Rolick. Rolick tries to get it out, but somebody lost it. Edge went down, and having a little trouble clearing it. Karsma over to Rolick again. Back to Karsma. And now to Austin. Austin gets it into center ice. Good pass there by to Dooley ahead. Dooley going down. Shot goes in. Knocked away. Loose puck behind the net. Put right on the net and covered up by Richards, the goalie, but there's a little shoving going on after the stoppage after the whistle. And I don't think he's assessed any penalties. He's just...
2 minutes
roughing for number 8 for Dexter. So that's Wes Gilbert. So, puck shot in there. Richards makes that save, but then the rebound made the initial save, and the rebound was knocked in. You know whether we got the on the replay or not, I didn't get the score.
9-13-5.
Goal is number 9. Ian Melrose, the assist go to number 13, Gianni Bonello, and number 5, Shane Goldberg. Another power play goal. Two power play goals for the Bears. So those penalties have hurt the Dexter Dreadnoughts. Got taking advantage, the Bears taking advantage of those, that man advantage situation both times. Flannery. That'll be another icing. That'll bring it back down into the Bears' end. Faceoff coming down to the stick side of Stephen Rowe. Cameron Milne to take the faceoff against Kuby. Kuby winds up control, set it into center ice. Going back there after Ben Grover for Dexter. Grover gets it ahead. And Rojek. Rojek's shot deflected by the glove of Stephen Rowe. And the Bears trying to clear it, but kept in and shot in behind the net. And there, Tristan Rojek trying to get to it, but broken up, and but Rojek again picks it up. Rojek with a 360 on the that and shot it right across in front. Nobody could get a stick down on it. Coming out, James Bauer trying to get it cleared. They do get it cleared to center ice. Shot back in. Murphy going back, or Rolick going back after it. Rolick over to Bauer on the opposite wing, but Cameron Milne there manages to keep it alive, puts it in behind the Berkeley net. Rojek. Rojek tries to center it, but the Bears get it out. Bala gets it out, shoots it ahead to Murphy. Too far. Going to go down the ice. But no icing. And the Bears make a wholesale line change. Goldberg. Over on the opposite wing, too. Nervous. Goldberg back. That's Dooley. Goldberg looking, and he gives it up to Dooley. Good forecheck there by number 7, Drew Glappa for Dexter. And coming out here is Jervis. Jervis skating it through center ice, gives it over to Dooley. Dooley takes a shot, deflected by the defenseman, number 20, Billy Howitt. Tucked in behind the net. Trying to get set up and coming in, get that, try to get shot off. Kevin Jervis gets knocked down, and Dexter comes the other way. In behind the net. Waiting for it there is Evan Morrison for Dexter, trying to keep it going. And now coming out, shot down there, swings to Ryan Austin. It's good down the ice. Melrose battling with it with Connor Harmon for it. Now picked up here by number 15, Brian Tuzanowski. Back into the Berkeley end. Robbie Flannery picks it up. Down along the board. Joachim Eriksson. Going to get it loose. Johnny Bonello in behind the net. Dexter tries to clear it, but Bonello keeps it in there. Puts it in. Connor Harmon picks it up for Dexter, trying to get it cleared. But the Bears are keeping the pressure on. Kept in there by number 42, Joakim Eriksson. Yeah. Delayed penalty coming up to the Dexter Dreadnoughts.
Dexter 8, minor slashing.
Dexter penalty is a number, again on number 8, that's Wes Gilbert for a slash with 3:37 remaining here in the first period. So the Bears again, man advantage. With 2 minutes or less, they've taken advantage of the last two. Rolick tries to get it clear. Flannery puts it in. Dexter trying to get it out, and Flannery still manages to flip it in behind. There, going back there is Curtis Carnes. Bears finally clear it loose. Ahead to Zach Siegel in the opposite wing to number 43, Kevin Jervis. Jervis picks it up, drops it back to Flannery. Flannery shot from just inside the blue line. Richards made the save, didn't really look like he knew for sure where it was for a moment there. Jervis drops it in behind to Karn. Karn wheels around behind the net. Brings it all the way back out, drops it back in. Picking up there, 19, Zach Siegel. Siegel gives it back to Flannery. Flannery shot, deflected. Karn going to center it, and Richards made the save, and that time covered it up. 2:19 remaining here in the first period. Bears enjoying a 2-0 lead over the Dexter Dreadnoughts. 42 seconds remaining in the power play opportunity for the Bears. The third one they've had in this game, and picked up Bonello. Goldberg drops it in. Looking to get set up right in front. Right on the doorstep is Eriksson. Eriksson's right there, and Richards made that save. He's had a lot of challenges to answer in this first period. And those penalties aren't helping him any. Melrose here to take the faceoff for the Bears. Melrose clears it back. Goldberg shot. Deflected by the defense in front. And Dexter comes the other way. Rojek. Tristan Rojek. Rojek. And good job by Karsima. Break it up. And Bonello. Shoots it ahead to Goldberg. Shane Goldberg. Oh, excuse me. That's Ian Melrose. Ian Melrose. Melrose. Trying to center it. Goldberg shot. Is deflected aside by right in front of the goal. Dexter trying to get the puck cleared. It can't, and then the Bears keeping the pressure on. Dexter finally does get the center ice. Rojek. Rojek seems to be most of their offense, and Rojek puts it in the net. Tristan Rojek, with 1 minute remaining in the period, gets the Dreadnoughts on the board.
2 from 9.
The goal, Tristan Rojek. The assist, number 9, Derek Smith. Austin here to take the face off against Wes Gilbert. Gilbert controls it, knocks it back here to Ben Grover. Flannery in the center ice. And Dexter shoots it back in. Steven Roback drops it over for number eight, Christian Santiago. Shot. Goes in and glove save made by Steven Rowe. 2-1. Berkeley leads this contest. And they go out for the line change. Karn, Melrose, and Siegel come in. Goldberg and Rolick on the defense. Melrose going on the left wing, gives it ahead to Karn. Karn looking for the opening. Flips it over to Melrose. Melrose shot. We got, I think that must have gone up and hit the net. I didn't see where it went. You notice down there at that end of the rink, you see all those faces. Those are the nine seniors that were introduced earlier. They're blown up faces and good shots of all of them. Right back here, Rolick puts it in behind the net. Elro centers it. Broken up there by number eight, Wes Gilbert for Dexter. It's up along the board to get it to center ice, but that's going to end this period. The score at the end of one, the Berkeley Ferndale United Bears 2 and Dexter Dreadnoughts 1. 2-1. We'll be right back with the second period.
Live with a human for a while and you get to know a few things. Like, I know she's actually not a morning person. I know she does strange tricks for no treats. I know that water makes her howl like crazy. I even know how the floors stay so clean. She's quick. But the one thing I will never for the life of me know is how she gets so tiny and inside that box. Natalie, how do you get so tiny?
Welcome back to Berkeley Ice Arena for tonight's game between the Berkeley Ferndale United Bears and the Dexter Dreadnoughts. The end of the first period, the score, Berkeley 2, Dexter 1. Goals coming in the first period for the Bears by Gianni Bonello with an assist to Ian Melrose, and then the second one went. The goal was Ian Melrose with the assist going to Gianni Bonello and Shane Goldberg. And Dexter, with 1 minute remaining in the period, got on the board for the first time with a goal by Tristan Rojek with an assist from Derek Smith. So that brings us to 2-1. But as that period ended, we had an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty to Ian Melrose for the Bears. So the Bears will start out the second period shorthanded. The Dexter Dreadnoughts will have the man advantage for the first 2 minutes here of the period. Shot back into the Dexter end by Siegel. Siegel on the forecheck, slowing down the Dexter team. Dexter coming out with it, number three, Connor Harmon. Comes down, puck in behind the net. Robbie Flannery picks it up for the Bears, tries to clear it, doesn't get it out. Picked up there, shot in there by number 15, Brian Tuzanowski. And along the boards, Cameron Milne drops it back to Tuzanowski. Tuzanowski shot deflected wide. Milne picking it up. Milne drops it back. It goes back again to Tuzanowski. To number eight, Wes Gilbert. Gilbert skating in. deflected away and shot down the ice. And going back after it is Connor Harmon for Dexter. Coming out. And down the shot goes wide. Shot by E.J. Gilbert goes wide. Puck went out of play, and referee went to get another one, so. Dexter picks it up, number 19, E.J. Gilbert. Puts it around behind the boards. The Bears are going to control it. So they don't get it out, though, and Dexter keeps it in. One down, loses an edge, goes down. That's number 13, Freddie Burke. Back around the boards to Wes Gilbert. Drop back to Sean Fitzsimon. But now taken away there by number 43, Kevin Jervis, who gets it out to center ice. Dexter going back in. Number 13, Freddie Burke. And shot down the ice as the penalty is about to expire. And the Bears are back to full strength. And up and push it back into the Dexter end there. Ben Grover for Dexter trying to get started, but Erickson, Joakim Erickson, comes in and ties him up behind the net. Dropped around there. Rolick picks it up, but picked up away there by Wes Gilbert for. And E.J. Gilbert gets a shot in on Stephen Rowe. Stephen covers it up. Wes Gilbert fed it over to E.J. Gilbert, and E.J. Gilbert put the shot on the net. Kind of just a rolling puck, wasn't really a hard shot, and Steven just covered it up. 14:33 remaining here in the second period. Teams are at full strength. Coming around, the Bears trying to clear it. Bonello kicks it out, and then Dexter comes back with it. Shot goes in, shot put in there, and Rowe covers up. Cameron Milne. Puts that shot in. And again, the face-up comes up to the stick side of goaltender Stephen Rowe. Right point-blank shot there by Tristan Rojek. But now here come the Bears the other way. Coming down, it's Kevin Jervis. Puts it into the corner, but Erickson there. Flipped out. Flipped back in behind the net, and Dexter picks it up to Tuzanowski. Tuzanowski shoots it down the ice. Rojek. Shot is deflected. You see where the linesman was lining up. Puck went out. Offside, and it here's Rolick for the Bears. The center ice back into the Dexter end. One down for Dexter, number 19, E.J. Gilbert. E.J. Gilbert goes around behind the net. Met there and stopped by James Bauer. Puts it back around the boards to Rolick. Rolick puts it up along the boards. Number 91, James Jacob Murphy. Skating it in there, number 13, Freddie Burke for the Dreadnoughts. Trying to get it going and puts it off the side of the net. Coming back here, Jacob Murphy trying to clear it. Now it's shot the center. Going back after it is Ben Grover for Dexter. Murphy forechecking there. And coming out with it, coming down the ice. Number 13, that's Freddie Burke. Burke shot deflected. Shot right, put right across in front. Puck in behind the net. Kubi goes down. Kubi picks it up. This time, Goldberg manages to shoot it down the ice. And picking it up there with Billy Howlett for Dexter, but they go for a line change. Dooley gives it ahead to Karn. Karn gets around behind the net, drops it back to number eight, Christian Santiago, but broken up and going down the other way, number 13, Freddie Burke. For, and we've got a penalty coming up again to the Dexter Dreadnoughts. Let's say touch it up. No, oh, it was a, I thought he called a penalty. I saw it. Yeah. Or was it offside? It was delayed offside. Okay. They're, just, they're going back the other way. There's Drew Klapa, which is an in toward the net. But now here come the Bears down. Dooley gives it to Siegel. Siegel shot. And glove save made by Dexter goaltender Zach Richards. James Bowell was out of stick. For a moment there. Back into the corner. Bonello. Erickson pitching in. Erickson picks it up. Erickson drops it back. The shot goes in there by Robbie Flannery. Flannery drops it in behind the net. Back there for Dexter picking it up. Number five, Sid Simon, is up to Slanderer. Back is out to center ice. And taken away there by number nine, Derek Smith. Derek Smith shoots in. Shot goes wide. Back around the boards. Pinello trying to pick it up. Pinello gets tangled up there with Derek Smith. Rojek trying to get centered and taken away and shot down the ice there by Joakim Eriksson. Back the other way. Eriksson dumped pretty hard there by Slanderer. He got a whistle. I think Slanderer is going.
Four white liner interference. 2 minutes. Interference.
Number four, Jake Slanderer. 2 minutes for interference. So the Bears with a new power play advantage. Bears are 2 for 3 on the power play so far tonight. So they converted two of them, but this one, good effort there by Evan Morrison to break it up, and now coming back for the Bears. Jervis wheels back. Jervis over 26, Ryan Austin. Ahead to Dooley. And the defense flips it out the center, going back after Jerry Karsma. Pass across to Dooley. Dooley stops, drops it back to Karsma. To Dooley. Back behind the net. To Karsma pinches it in, keeps it alive. In behind the net to Austin. But too far, Jervis picks it up. Jervis up to back Goldberg. Jervis shot. Knocked away by the goaltender. Picked up there by the number 18 for Dexter. That's Evan Morrison. Manages to clear it into center ice. Now as the Bears get partial line change, Melrose shot is deflected up and into the net. And the faceoff will be outside the blue line. 8:59 remaining here in the second period. 38 seconds remaining in a penalty to Jake Slanderer. The Bears, Erickson over too far for Pinello. Back here to Rolick. roll it to Melrose. Melrose shot, save made by Richards. Bonello picks it up, rebound. Wheels around, drops it back to Melrose. Melrose to Flannery, too far, and it goes back to center ice. Goldberg back trying to pick it up. Goldberg gives it to Flannery. Back to Goldberg. Goldberg on the opposite side. They come in, and Erickson couldn't get the shot away. Rolick shoots it back in. Picking up Billy Howlett for Dexter. Does get it to center ice. Rojek on down there with it. And the Bears come back the other way. Here comes Ian Melrose. Ian Melrose shot up over the net. Kuby. And taken away back there by number 11, Cameron Milne. Center ice, Kuby picks it back up, shoots it in wide. Going over there to get it, number 19, Zach Siegel. Goldberg keeps it alive. Back to Kuby. Kuby shot, bounces high in the air and caught there. And Brian Tuzanowski starting it out to center ice. Ahead to number 9, Derek Smith. It looks to, almost like the Dreadnoughts are rolling two lines. It looks like they're playing with a short bench because it does a lot of people. The same six forwards seem to be on the ice all the time. McDonald is now in the net for the Bears. I didn't even notice the change. Flipped in there by Connor Harmon. Going back after it for the Bears, number 19, Zach Siegel. Trying to get it clear, Karn. Karn does get it to center ice. Shot is deflected up into the Bears bench. And the faceoff will be in center ice. We're back into the Dexter end. Okay. Tuzanowski gets it ahead to number 10, Tommy Finn. Got back in, Harmon shoots it down the ice for the Dreadnoughts. Kept in, put around behind the net. Robbie Flannery picking it up for the Bears. Flannery up ahead. There's Austin. Austin still manages to get around him and keep control. Good job there by Ryan Austin to keep control of that puck. Jervis drops it to Dooley. Dooley back to Austin behind the net. He's checked at the boards there, and Dooley going to pick it back up again, give it back to Austin. Austin skates right out in front, puts it in. I don't know whether it was in the net or not. And get the call from the referee.
23-26, slashing.
A penalty on Berkeley. Number 26, Ryan Austin for slashing. Two minutes for slashing for Ryan Austin, number 26. So now the Dexter squad has their second power play opportunity of this period. Period. squared down into the Dexter end, but now Dexter bringing it back the other way, going in there after Cameron Milne, shoots around behind the boards. Dexter trying to set up. There's number nine, Derek Smith. Drops it back to number 17, Grover. Looking to set up. And the Bears, Curtis Karn manages to clear it down the ice. As a good effort there, and a forecheck by number 19, Zach Siegel. Now broken up, Raleigh. Raleigh trying to break it up. It goes up in the air, and that's going to go into the Dexter bench. Let's see where they line that face up. Face off up. Just out. Just outside the Bears blue line. Melrose, the control comes up with the Dexter squad. Back in there, number 13 for Dexter Centers, right across in front. Battle along the boards for it. A couple of bodies go down. Melrose is down. Now picking up the shot put in there. Number 8, Gilbert put that shot in, knocked away, and then the rebound by Freddie Burke, knocked away. Now Bears come out with the Robbie Flannery. Flannery sends it down. It goes, bounces off the back of the net. 18 seconds remaining in the penalty. Connor Harmon puts it up on the boards, but Melrose breaks it up. Melrose drops it back, and the Bears keep it in. They'll pretty much end that penalty. Dexter goes down, shoots it down the ice, broke it up, shot into center ice. The partial line change coming up with it. Here comes Melrose. Melrose shot right into the midsection of Richards. And Richards makes the save. Score remains Berkeley 2, Dexter 1. 3:32 remaining here in the second period. Both teams at full strength. Siegel centering Karn and Jervis. Raleigh back at the point. Can't control it, keep it in. And the Bears clear it and get it back in. Now shot to center ice ahead to number 9, Derek Smith. Derek Smith is taken away from him, but Rojek shoots it up ahead to Cameron Milne. Milne is stopped down there, and the Bears manage to break it up, but they don't clear it out. And this time it gets shot right back in on Rob McDonald. And Rob McDonald makes the save and holds on. 3 minutes even remaining here in the period. Faceoff cleared in behind the Bears' net. And the Bears come out with it. Back to center ice. Good collision there as Siegel takes down Cameron Milne. Shot in behind the net. Going back there to get it. Sean Fitzsimons puts it up along the boards. Back to Cameron Milne. Milne gives it over to number 9, Derek Smith. Derek Smith gets down with it. Broken up. Picked up and dropped back to the number 17, Ben Grover at the point. Grover shot. He's deflected aside. Rolick tries to clear it. Grover keeps it in, though, and Rolick takes him down. Here it comes the other way. Joakim Eriksson. Joakim Eriksson shot. Saved made by Eriksson, by Richards. Up along the boards, number 19, E.J. Gilbert, but broken up by Melrose. Melrose gave it over to Eriksson. Eriksson shot, did not get through. And Stephen Rose going to fall down, hold on to that one as number 13, Freddie Burke was skating right in on him, and there was no defenseman to protect him. Dexter to manage to keep it in, keep it alive. Bonello trying to clear it, but kept in there by number 13, Freddie Burke. Burke puts it in behind the net. Robbie Flannery picks it up. Gets it out to center ice. Ahead to Dooley. Dooley shot across in front. Nobody was there. Bonello puts it over the opposite wing to Melrose. Melrose tries to center it up. Dooley's shot goes up off the glass. Opening up there for a minute. Melrose picks it up back to Dooley. Back to Ian Melrose. Flip back. Kept in there. Karsma keeps it alive at the point. Into Ian Melrose. Melrose shot goes in on Richards and he makes the save and holds on. 44 seconds remaining here in the period. Both teams will make a line change for this last 44 seconds. Stretch here. Siegel centering Karn and Jervis. Siegel carries it back to Rolick. Rolick puts it in behind the net. Bears trying to get it going. Karn pushes Harmon into the boards. Harmon gives it to Rojek. Rojek through center ice. Ahead. Go back to Rojek. Bears break it up. Now number 9 picks it up. It's Derek Smith. Shot down into the Berkeley end. Goldberg back. Flips it into center ice. But then up there is Cezanowski. Goldberg flips it off to the opposite wing. Jervis can't get to it. Big hit there. Siegel. Siegel takes down Rojek. And that's going to end the period. And I think that the referee wants to talk to both Siegel and Rojek. I think they had a collision after the whistle. I don't think he's going to call any penalties. He's just telling them no penalty call, but just a word of warning from the officials. That collision after the whistle got the referee's attention. So at the end of two periods, the score, Berkeley 2 and Dexter 1. We'll be back with the third period in just a few moments. Ice Arena for the third period of tonight's game between the Berkeley Ferndale United Bears and the Dexter Dreadnoughts. It was 2-1 at the end of the first. It remains 2-1. No score in that second period. And one minor penalty apiece, or actually two minor penalties for the Bears, one for Dexter, but no one was able to convert on a power play. And we're going to be going to the third period with the score still 2-1, the Bears leading. Bears would like to get this one under their belt as they go into the state tournament next Tuesday against Fraser High School. Sure, they would like to celebrate tonight for the senior night event. Melrose out there controls the faceoff. Back to Robbie Flannery. Flannery over to Goldberg. Goldberg shoots it across to Bonello. Too far, and Dexter manages to send it back the other way. Flannery over to Goldberg. Goldberg ahead to Erickson. Joachim Erickson puts it in behind the net. Dexter trying to clear it, but the Bears keep it alive. Melrose spins, goes wide. Puck down along the ice and shot back in by the Bears. Flannery pitches in, but Dreadnoughts get it to center ice. Battle on center ice for it, and Flannery picks it up again. Flannery shoots it ahead, too. Number 28, Max Dooley. The Dreadnoughts going to come out with it. Number 19, E.J. Gilbert comes out and tries to get it started, but can't, and the Bears keep it in. Carson's shot was deflected, and now it's back out to the point to Rolick, the opposite point. Rolick puts it in behind the net to Dooley. Back to Jervis. Jervis is it back to Dooley. Dooley skating it in. Goes around behind the net. Looks to set up. Tries to center it, but it gets back behind the net. Going back here to get it is Austin. And knocked out the center ice by Dexter and shot down here to Rojek. Shot in there by Cameron Milne. And a save made by Rob McDonald. Rob McDonald in the net for the second half of this game. He changed goaltenders in the second period. Goes wide. Back out to the point here, Brian Tuzanowski gives it ahead to Derek Smith. Smith to Cameron Milne. Goes in behind the net and goes off the side of the net, and McDonald holds on to it. Faceoff will come up to the stick side of Rob McDonald. Siegel throws it back to Flannery. Flannery puts it around the boards. It's out the center and it's going all the way down. Curtis Karn comes up with it. Curtis Karn shot is into the pads of Zach Richards, and he manages to hold on. Didn't look 100% sure he knew where it was. There comes, here's a good shot here of Curtis Karn, and flipped it up. And Richards stops it. Shane Goldberg. And then deflected shot over to Karn. Karn redirects it, and it goes into Richards, and he holds on for another faceoff. 2-1, Berkeley leads this one. With 14:25 remaining here in the third period. Goldberg. Flanderer comes out with it, gives it ahead to number 8, West Gilbert. Gilbert shoots it down to McDonald. Rob Flannery back there to pick up for the Bears. Flannery goes behind his net, but going in there on the forecheck, number 13, Freddie Burke, taking it away. But Melrose picks it up. Melrose gets it out ahead to Erickson. Erickson to Bonello. Bonello shoots it in. Bonello's going to go into the corner with it. Picks it up, gives it to Melrose. Melrose. Melrose trying to get out in front. Melrose poking at it. Puck was loose for a minute there, but now it's picked up by number 5, Sean Fitzsimons. For Dexter, and shot back into the Bears' end. Going back there, Carson, I guess, puts it into center ice. Now picking up Pinellas and Rowick, keeping it in at the point there. Going back after Sean Fitzsimons. Along the boards for it. Back here, Jervis picks it up, sends it over to Rolick. Ahead to Max Dooley. Dooley gets it right in front, and Richards grabs it and holds on again. As you want to leave that rebound laying there because Ryan Austin was right on the doorstep. We'll go for a line. The lines are going to change. He just puts it out. Shot in there by Goldberg. Deflected away, and Dexter comes out with it. They're broken up by the Bears. They got an offside. Siegel there to take the faceoff against Drew Glappa. Siegel draws it back to Goldberg. Goldberg into center ice, flipped back in by number 18, Evan Morrison, for Dexter, but the Bears pick it up. Melrose. Melrose into center ice. Going down there, Curtis Karn breaks it up, takes it away, and Curtis Karn puts it in the net. Curtis Karn. I think the one assist will go to Melrose, but we'll get the scoring in a moment.
23 from 19.
The goal is Curtis Karn. The assist go to 19, Zach Siegel. With 12:28 remaining here, the Bears take a 3-1 lead. Siegel gives it ahead to Melrose. Broken up in front there by number 15, Cezanowski. And here comes Cezanowski out with it. Ahead to number 11, Cameron Milne. It's broken up there and picked up away. Again, Melrose. Melrose this time is Siegel. Siegel shot knocked away. In the corner. Going back to pick it up. Flannery, as served by Queers, puts it back into the Dexter end. Connor Harmon, pick it up back there. Harmon, behind the net. Puts it up along the boards, but pinching in there is Carson. Carson keeping it live for the Bears. And Bonello in there in the forecheck. Picked in at the point there by Ryan Austin. Austin right on the doorstep. They're looking to get set up. In behind to Bonello. Ryan Austin shot. Deflected aside. Back into the Berkeley end. Bobby Flannery puts it ahead to Bonello. It's broken up there by Wes Gilbert for Dexter. Flannery comes out. Taken away from him by number 13, Freddie Burke. Freddie Burke tries to wrap around and it doesn't work, and Flannery gets it to center ice. Back in behind the net. Going back there after is Carsima. Carsima. Gonna control it, now Carsima again picks it up. To Jervis. Jervis gets it out to center ice. He's got a cross check.
Dexter
penalty, number 13, Freddie Burke. 2 minutes for cross checking. 10:16 remaining here in the third period. Freddie Burke, 2 minutes cross check. And the Bears again have a power play advantage. Austin puts that right across the front of the net there, and now the Bears really putting pressure on. Richards makes that save, makes a rebound save, and the Bears still controlling the puck. Now put in again. There goes Karn. Karn drops it back to Rolick. Rolick shot. Gets deflected aside. If the defense got a hold of that. Austin. Drops it back. Rolick at the point. Drops it back. Austin centers it. Rolick's going to control it there. Drops it over to Goldberg. Goldberg shot knocked away by the goalie. Austin shot was in. And Richards covers that one up. A lot of opportunities for the Bears in that little stretch from just 1 minute and 4 seconds into that penalty, and it looks like I think they had four shots on the net, I think, in that period of time. And Richards was able to deflect them all aside. Still 56 remaining in the penalty. The shot by Carsima goes wide. Flannery drops it ahead to Erickson. Erickson to Melrose. Melrose back out to Flannery. Flannery shot. Erickson tries to redirect it. He can't get to it. Back to Flannery again. Flannery over to Melrose. Back to Flannery. Flannery shot. Knocked away, and I don't think that got all the way through. The Bears still controlling the puck. Dropped in behind to Melrose. Melrose drops it back the other way to Erickson. Erickson back to Melrose. Melrose out to Carsima. Back to Melrose. Melrose taken down in front. And Dexter finally clears it down the net. And they're back to full strength. Flannery gives it ahead. Gianni Bonello. Battling for it. And picks up. Here comes number 11, Cameron Milne, coming down. Tries to center it across, and nobody there. Bonello gets it back to center ice. And there's defense stopping everything out there. Rob McDonald goes back, drops it for a Rolick. Rolick gets it out ahead to Siegel. Ahead to Mel. Murphy. Jacob Murphy. Gets it down into the Dexter end. Bears still trying to get that offense started. Goldberg drops it back. Go back to Goldberg. Goldberg's shot goes through. Knocked away by Richards in front. And coming out is Wes Gilbert for the Dreadnoughts. Gilbert shot right into the midsection of Rob McDonald. He grabs it in that big mitt and holds on. 7:03 remaining. The Bears lead this one 3-1. Flanderer's shot deflected by Jacob Murphy. Now they get out. Flanderer picks it back up again. Flanderer's shot goes wide. The other side. Jervis picks it up behind the net for the Bears. Ahead to Dooley. Back to Jervis. Back to Dooley again. Dooley goes down. The shot attempt there by Dexter doesn't get through. This one does get through, and Bob McDonald makes the save. Jervis sit out in the center ice. Going back after it, Sean Fitzsimons for Dexter. Simons broken up by Flannery. Flannery shot. Glove save made by Zach Richards. And the faceoff will come up to the stick side of Zach Richards. 6:14 remaining. Bears are definitely controlling play pretty much now most of this period. Kept in there, kept alive by the Bears. Can be shot in there by Kuby. Shot down the ice, and Rojek comes down there and And that'll be an icing. Rojic tried to get it before it went over the icing line, but he did not get there in time. Siegel draws it back to, I think that was Chrissy Santiago. It was Chrissy Santiago. Back. Milne going in after it for Dexter. Got a whistle. Got an interference penalty coming up. I believe it's the number 11. Cameron Milne. Cameron Milne. 2 minutes for interference. 5:35 remaining. Number 11, Cameron Milne. Interference. Bears again on the man advantage, the power play opportunity. They've had a shot that was in front and knocked aside by the defense. But there Erickson battling for it behind the board, behind the net. Back out to the point. There, shot by Goldberg. Wide, deflected wide. Bonello picks it up. Bonello drops it back to Melrose. To Flannery, over to Melrose. Melrose shot and save made by Zach Richards. .445 remaining in the third period. .110 remaining in the penalty to Cameron Milne. And the Dexter Dreadnoughts have hurt themselves with the penalties today. Two power play goals are the difference. The shot in there by Curtis Karn, knocked away, back up along the boards, but kept in. The Bears do keep it alive again, and now it's sent to center ice. Driving back to get it is Karsma over to Rolick, back to Karsma, ahead to Siegel's pass too far for Ryan Austin. Austin gets it around behind the net, gives it to Siegel. Siegel goes around behind the net with it. He's trying to get it back out to the point. Rolick shot, deflected wide. And kept in by Karsma, but now coming out with it, number 7 down through Glapa. We got a whistle. Outside, apparently. The Bears, 12 seconds left in the power play opportunity. Jervis drops it back to Goldberg. Over to 28 to Dooley. They're not the other way. They're back to full strength. Right out in front. Now Flannery picks it up. And that goes off into the Dexter bench. They lined up to the glove side of Zach Richards, and I think the Dexter bench put it a little bit outside. Flannery pitching in. People trying to keep it alive. About 5 sticks in there. Battle for it. Shot around. And kept alive by the Bears, and then Dooley's shot goes up over the net. Flannery up the center ice, ahead to Goldberg. Goldberg dumps it in as they go for a line change. Dexter coming down, trying to get started. Ian Melrose picks it up. Melrose gives it ahead to Goldberg. Bonello picks it up, but Bonello takes it away. Bonello's shot knocked down by Richards in front. Erickson over to Rolick. Back behind the net there, the number 10, Carlisle. There's some other people getting some ice time here. Gianni Bonello. Gianni Bonello, stick saved by Richards, and then on the rebound, he dives and covers it up. 2:04 remaining. I don't know if they will, with being down two, will they will try to pull the goalie or try and get back into this one. Back in behind the net. Erickson back to get it. Erickson battled with Connor Harmon for it. Now Melrose joins it. Back out there, picked out by Raleigh at the blue line. Raleigh's shot goes in, and Zach Richards makes the save. He's Zach has earned his keep tonight. Well, a lot of shots on him, and he's managed to stop all but three of them. Dexter gets it to center ice, but broken up. But Carlisle shoots it back the other way. Now Dexter. Rojek shot goes up over the net. And a rebound put out in front, but broken up there by Bauer. Now Cameron Milne drops it. Now back there to Harmon. Over here to Derek Smith. Derek Smith puts it in the center, but Kubi picks it up there. Kubi. And just a little too much stick handling, and somebody, one of his line mates, crossed the line, that blue line, just ahead of him. 1:12 remaining. Bears lead this one 3-1. Pretty much desperation time here for the Dexter Dreadnoughts, if they can try and do something. And Dexter calls a timeout. Use their timeout and it looks pretty good for the Bears right now. There's a look at Coach Brian Sippets talking to his team. He's in his third year at Dexter. Says that they have played pretty close games against Berkeley the last few years. It's always good when you can get keep on some of these non-league matchups going. We'll see what kind of strategy he's come out with to try and get himself on the board, and whether he's going to make some plans to take Zach Richards out of the net. Bears come out with Karn, Siegel, and Erickson. Up back here, Erickson flips it into the Dexter end. Going back there after for Dexter, number 17, Ben Grover. Try and get it out ahead. They get it into center ice. Can't get it through to Rojek. And Karn comes back the other way with it. Curtis Karn. Shot, not save made by Richards. Another save on another shot, but a third one, the third rebound went in, the third shot went in. Zach Richards saved two of those, but the third one went in the net. The Dexter team questionnaire's Karn shot, There's a second shot that went off the blocker. And there's the third one. Looks like Siegel, Zach Siegel. We'll get the scoring as soon as the official is discussing it over here, but I'm pretty sure that's going to be Zach Siegel with 50 seconds remaining. I didn't see who took the second shot. The first shot was Curtis Karn. I don't know what the controversy was. We'll get the scoring.
They have 19 unassisted at this point right now, okay?
They call it 19 unassisted, but I'm going to go from whoever made that first shot. Erickson. It's going to actually be when they score it. When they actually review it, though, I'm sure it'll be Curtis Karn and number 42, Joakim Eriksson. Joakim Eriksson shot that first rebound, which went off the blocker, and then Zach Siegel skated right in, dropped it in. It's pretty clear on the rebound, or on the replay. Slander are going back after it for Dexter. 4-1, the Bears lead this one. Pretty much all over but the shout now for the Dexter Rolick and Kubi battle. With the shot put in on the net there by number 10. Tommy Finn still playing. That's good. I see, and that's going to go all the way back into the no icing. They had to play it before it got there. And they're coming down. That's going to end the contest. The Berkeley Bears come away with a victory in their final regular season game. The Berkeley Bears 4 and Berkeley Ferndale United Bears 4 and Dexter Dreadnoughts 1. So you see the teams. The team will line up and shake hands, and good contest for the Berkeley Bears as they go on to the playoffs. They go on with a record of 17-6-2. And in good shape as they go into the playoffs against Fraser on Tuesday night. This is you. This is you, Scullin, for Community Media Network, thanking you for tuning in to tonight's Berkeley Ferndale United Bears hockey. We'll see you back here next season, I'm sure. Thank you very much, everybody. Good night, everybody.